Okay, remember this is just a technique. There are several possibilities and several correct techniques. Om Shri in the third eye, which is the mind control center. In other words, there is a part of you which can control the mind, and that's in the third eye here. The third eye is not a physical eye here, but it's in the etheric, physical, astral, and mental, and causal dimension. It's the invisible space here, in the interdimensional space. There is a faculty which is completely asleep or sleeping in the human being, but that can be used to control the thought processes. You know, if you focus into the third eye with the correct technique, it will control your mind. It will stop you thinking. It will actually positively stop the waves, the mental waves, so that you can attain that calmness which is necessary for enlightenment. Okay, so now to help the third eye to do this work, we have a sound structure called Om Shri, which you intone in the third eye. And the significance of that is that in Sanskrit, we can use a Hebrew model, or we can use Sanskrit model, or we can use the Arabic Sufi model. It doesn't matter which you know, model we can use. We can use several kind of models, but this is very handy for most people who start a Sanskrit model, because it's very universal. It's kind of anybody can practice it. Even the most materialistic people can practice it. It doesn't matter. It's just a universal something you can do. And when we say the Om sound, it tends to concentrate the energy in the third eye. Om. It's already by nature, the Om sound by nature resonates in the third eye here. It's like it's a sound structure. It's a vibration frequency which already resonates here. Om. It resonates up here. Answer the phone. Okay, now the other one is that the Shri, whereas the sound, the frequency, the vibration of Om focuses the attention here, and thereby calming the mind down. Because, you know, what the beautiful part of this technique is that it enables your mind to keep going and reduce itself by itself. In other words, you don't say stop. No, you direct the mind, redirect it by itself. So what it is, you say Om. Well, the Om itself, like a sound formula, actually starts directing your mind, so that the mind, rather than going like this, it begins to flow along the river. The Om, you know, you say Om, so the mind says Om. Why is that noise again? Anyhow, it will go along that line. But that's not the end of it, because the Om will focus the mental energy in one point, in one direction, but something else happens at that point, the Shri. Now, Shri means light, okay? Shri is like brilliance or brightness. You know, it's like a dazzling sort of a phenomena. Shri literally just means dazzling or bright or brilliant, okay? So there's a brilliant light exists in the third eye already. It exists in your in your being, except it hasn't been awakened. That brilliant light is here. Okay, so what the Om Shri does is that it tells your mind to go into the third eye and discover the light. It's simply, in terms of occult reality, Om Shri says, go in there, my mind, discover the light, become the light, one with the light. So that the waves like that, they just become quieter and quieter, and there is a spark. That's when the Om connected to the Shri. And as you practice it more, the spark becomes like a flame. And from the flame, it becomes like a furnace of bright light, until the whole universe becomes a brilliance, the white brilliance, the supreme crown in Kabbalah, the white brilliance of the supreme crown, the Godhead, okay? So you can discover the Godhead here in the third eye. Okay, so that's a beautiful technique, and it's one amongst many possibilities, but I just chose this one because it's simply everybody can practice it, and you don't have to become a Hindu or a Buddhist or anybody else. You can even remain a materialist if you want to. But don't watch so many television programs, but do also this. And then you have another amazing television, the inner television here. Beautiful stuff. Absolutely, unbelievably beautiful stuff you can see inside. Okay, so what we're going to practice that, so that at least you have one technique for the calmness of thoughts, which is a correct technique. As I said, it's important that you have correct techniques in this thing. So the way we're going to practice is that I'm going to tune it to you physically, because it's important that the physical brain hears the sound. It's actually a mental practice, but it's important first to hear the sound so that the physical brain adapts to that vibration, because the physical brain also vibrates. It's very, very slow, of course. Some people's brain really is very slow. You know. Okay, well, anyhow, so there's different degrees of slowness of the physical brain. Anyhow, so first you have to hear that sound so the physical brain can pick it up. And then, of course, we're going to do it mentally, which is the real practice. It's the mental practice. Okay, so we'll practice it physically first. And then when you do the mentally, then you just imagine like the third eye here. Don't worry about it, what it looks like. It's not important. Just concentrate on the sound. Om. Focusing your mental energy here. Shri. It's like coming to point and open up. And each time you're coming to the point and open up, the shri opens up the third eye like that. So in the beginning it may be just a little spark, or you see a few sparks of light. Later on it may become a very intense point. You see a little intense point of light, either here or there or somewhere. There's a triangle. The third eye actually, it's in a triangular shape. So sometimes you can see a point at this, an intense little point of light here or here or here, or actually move in different direction, okay, or at the center. It doesn't matter. That's not important. Anyhow, you see this little point, but this little point becomes like a light like that, or bigger and bigger and bigger until your whole body shall be full of light, like the Christ said. Unfortunately, the Christ, Jesus, he was speaking Aramaic. Aramaic was his language. And, of course, he was using the symbols and idioms of the Aramaic language of the day at that time. And he was explaining to his disciples this technique, that when you focus in the third eye here, then the ultimate result will be the universal light, or the light of the Father, the light of the Heavenly Father, what he called the Father, the Monad, okay? It becomes a white brilliance. But, of course, the way he was explaining it in the Aramaic language is that if these two eyes here, if you concentrate the energy, the rays of these two eyes to this point here, then in time it becomes full of light, okay? But the way, because of the translators have not received occult training or meditation training, they simply translate it from the Aramaic into Greek and from Greek into Latin, that if your eye be single, thy body shall be full of light. Well, the eye... You see, this eye is two eyes, not a single eye. And what, you know, like, because I don't understand the concept behind it, they're not translating it correctly. If your eye be single, well, most people have two eyes, not one eye, okay? And if your eye be single, one eye is already single. One eye cannot be single because it's already single. Your body shall be full of light. In other words, what, you know, if you really understand it, because of the wrong language translations, which is easy to make when you don't understand what the story is about, what he meant to say that these eyes, when they focused and become a single eye here, which is the original eye, sometimes called the single eye or the third eye, then your body shall be full of light. Not only the physical body, but the whole inner aura, your whole inner structure, your whole soul becomes a manifested light after a bit of a practice, of course. All right, so I'm going to intone it for you first, and we do it together physically, and then we do it mentally. And yeah, okay, just let's do that. Om Shree